And so many of us confuse that influence with power, but really you're in a place of purpose to help others and yourself propel forward with what they were really originally designed to do.
Right, and that's one of the things that that I just really enjoyed about it, because it kind of put in place that it is not a position of power. It's more of a position of purpose, and mm-hmm. so that you can help somebody else.
And that's it, because one of the things when we think about leaders in the workplace, you want to know that you've been given an authority. You've been given and you have been instilled in you, and you have been given, so to speak, empowered so that you can actually help lead others. And we get management and leadership mixed up. When you're managing things, you're managing processes, you're managing the day-to-day workflow, you're managing the outcomes of what the employees are doing. However, when you think about leadership, you are making an effective change in someone else and influencing them, not necessarily by monitoring their day-to-day actions, but you're influencing them by your behavior. And then you're also influencing them by bringing out the best in them. And so that's the difference when we think about those insecure leaders. You want to know that you serve from a place of purpose. And the one thing we shared, if you remember, Jermaine, we talked about insecure leaders lead from a place of fear.
Yes.
And they're afraid that someone else may come in and take their position, or they're trying to enforce a power that's not necessary for that particular position. And
right.
It's critical. It's critical.
It is.
Especially because it goes on so much.
Right, right. And one of the things that I added as well is the fact that, you know, that fear also is being seen that you're that person is really not qualified for their position.
Oh, that's the biggest part. But see, one thing that we have to remember, those of us who are believers in the workplace, and if you've ever served from a place of insecurity, you have to know that you're in leadership not because you know everything. It's because you can actually produce an outcome that's effective for that organization.
Right.
And so most people are promoted based on performance. They're not really based on are they able to lead others. And so you did well in a job as an individual contributor, and now you're actually promoted. And so what happens is we have this falsified reality somewhere. We've been told that if we are a leader, we're supposed to know everything.
Right.
But the true thing about a leader, and we said this a couple of weeks ago, is that you must be a servant leader.
Mm-hmm.
And that's being able to serve and also lead. And that means being able to honor the gifts that are in other individuals. So if you are good, Jermaine, in, you know, Microsoft Excel, or you're good at negotiating, data collection, communicating effectively, building relationships, as a leader, I'm going to help develop and maximize that particular strength and competency in you. And then if there is a weakness that I have on the team, I'm going to pull you in and say, Jermaine, let's come alongside. I want you to help and establish this in this particular time or on this particular project.
Right, right. And that's just some of the things that we've been talking about. So let me ask you this. So if we have that insecure leader, and this is something that we need to address as well, and we recognize that, or we believe that this is what's happening, how can we be successful subordinates to this person that's dangerous?
Listen, it's lethal.
Yeah.
If you've ever been under an insecure leader, it causes trauma. And we spoke about trauma. And trauma is anything that's, again, in the capacity of your mental space that's causing you fear, negative anxiety, stress. Those things cause trauma, and it's very traumatic. So, one, you want to make sure that you check your mental disposition, and you have to know that you're in that place, in that workplace, for a business. And
mm-hmm.
so you want to be professional and not personal. You want to make sure that you are effective in executing everything that you do. Now, here it is. Some people will say, well, make the leader feel needed. I don't think that that's necessary. I think you want to make sure that the leader doesn't feel threatened,
mm-hmm.
meaning I'm to support you as a part of your team. And so you want to show how you all can partner together to maximize their leadership position, but also your role as an employee. So here's the deal. We don't have to lead from a position in order to be a leader. So I would recommend when we're talking about how do we work with those individuals,
mm-hmm.
first of all, you want to make sure that it's professional.
Right.
You want to make sure that all the work that you're to do and everything that you're a part of is done in full excellence.
Mm-hmm.
You want to think
mm-hmm.
about it like this. And I was reading in the book of Daniel, and it was really just talking about when Daniel, when the king Nebuchadnezzar had called the boys in Judah to come out, and he said, go get them. He says, I want the best, I want the brightest, I want the most handsome. And he told them that, I want you to go get them, find them, and bring them to me, and then train them. And so I liken that to you go get the best and the brightest, and then you train them.
Right.
And so as someone on a part of a team of an insecure leader, I want you to know that when you partner with them, you say, you know what, I want to come alongside you, and I want to help develop that thing in that person. So you have to learn to have upward leadership. You have to be able to manage upward. And that's something that's a skill that you can practice. I've always managed upward. I've had leaders that were insecure, and I would manage up. I would say, you know what? Because if you think about it, and I was going somewhere with the story, King Nebuchadnezzar actually maximized Daniel's position in his kingdom. Under his leadership, he maximized his gift. So what I'm saying to you, when you go before someone who's an insecure leader who says, I'm going to kill everything that comes in my way, sort of like King Nebuchadnezzar, when they could not when they didn't understand how to interpret his dreams, he said, kill everybody.
Right.
So sometimes insecure leaders will come in and say, I don't have the ability, and I'm going to make sure that everything around me, if you don't perform at a certain level, I'm going to take you out too.
Mm-hmm.
But what Daniel did, he had a conversation. He says, hey, let me talk with the king. Let me let him know. Give me some time to go before my God, and I'll be able to do it. Sometimes you have to go before your God in order to have an interpretation of how to deal with a person.
Right.
And so I just want to share with you all out there, the Woody on Wednesday, wow, listeners, sometimes you got to go before your God and get an interpretation of what it is that your assignment is for this particular leader. See, the word says that we battle, you know, not against flesh and blood, but against spirituality, principalities, those evil things. And so we have to stop looking at everything from a carnal perspective, and also knowing that as believers, we are having spiritual warfare in the workplace, and you're going to have to sometimes go in and say, what is my assignment?
Mm-hmm.
And so I would recommend, for one, you need to know what you're dealing with. Two, you need to show up every time. Take your eyes off the personal and move into the professional.
Right.
Be very strategic in your assignment. Be very methodical in your movement and even in your conversation. So you want to make sure that you're self-aware and you're situationally aware about what you're doing with those type of leaders. You have to be very strategic. You cannot run it from an emotional perspective, because if you do, your emotions are going to run your outcome. Your emotions are going to run how you perform. And you know that in the workplace, the last thing you want to do is be an emotional wreck. You want to be very astute. You want to have business acuity. You want to learn everything that you can. Most importantly, you always execute at a high level of excellence. That would be my recommendation, Jermaine, because when we talk about insecure leaders, the best way to combat them is really showing them that I'm not a threat to you. I'm coming in and I'm assigned to you.
Right.
That's good stuff.
It is. It's great stuff. And so, and you touched on one of the points that I was thinking as you were speaking. You know, we have to put our purpose before what's personal, you know, to get past this sort of thing.
Yes. We have to make sure, because it's very sensitive in the workplace. I've been in positions, and even in the spirit of transparency, where I would always take things from a personal perspective. And I would say, well, they don't like me, or they, you know, they're afraid. Sometimes people have their own insecurities, and it's not personal. It's just that they have an issue, and it has nothing to do with you. But if I've also combated that particular spirit, first of all, with warfare and prayer, but also coming in with the spirit of excellence. Like, I leave no room for you to come back and say anything about my work. It's not operating from a scared place. It's operating from a place of wisdom.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
And so we have to learn to do that. We have to be wise in our dealings. We have to know when we're dealing with insecure leaders, they actually thrive from fear.
True. So true.
From fear, it's almost like feeding a plant. The more fear you feed that plant, the bigger it grows. So you want to think of someone who's insecure as someone who's feeding. I mean, it seems like an oxymoron, but it's really true. The more they feel like they're going to be found out, or the more they feel like someone's going to find that they are not as competent in an area. But here is the deal. When you are a leader, it's not saying you know everything. We have been taught to, you know, historically, systematically, even in the workplace, if you ask for help, that is a sign of weakness. But really, as a leader, when you ask for help, it's showing that you have a sign of strength, and you also know how to develop others.
Exactly.
When's the last time, again, Jermaine, the whole point of leadership is developing other leaders. You should be able to have someone in your position. When you get in your role, you should be looking for the next person to fill your role. You should be training up the next set of individuals who's going to take over your position so you can move forward. But instead, we try to protect our position because we feel like it's not enough. That's a scarcity mentality. It's not a spirit of abundance, and you're operating in a place that is not of God. You want to make sure that you are operating from, for those of us who are leaders, you want to make sure that you're full of abundance, knowing that there is more than enough, and you don't have to cut anyone off at the legs. You don't have to feel insecure and always self-promoting. Give others opportunities to come in and begin to develop them so that they can serve in their place in business.
That's right. And you know what, Dr. Kim, and I'm going to say this because I was thinking about this earlier, and I think that it fits because when we have those that are, you know, the insecure leaders, and we've talked about how to deal with those and how we can recognize those. Another way to recognize that is that if the one person, the person that's in charge or the leader that's in charge, if they leave and the whole organization can't flow and function as it should, that's not a good sign of a good leader. There's actually a kind of a different sign. I don't want to say a bad sign, but that says something about the organization, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Here's the deal. Again, we get the leadership mixed up with the managerial skills. They're two totally different things. And so sometimes leaders who are at the top of the food chain or those who are, again, in a position of authority, they actually have great managerial skills and they can get great outcomes, i.e. they can get the numbers and they can make that money, okay? So they can make it happen. They're making the numbers, but it doesn't necessarily mean that they're a great leader. And that's where we mix up our leadership and managerial positions. People who are great managers don't always make great leaders. And it does speak volumes about the company's culture. See, when you have a leader who is not effective and they're just running the business and they're not effectively developing and leading their people, then you have an organization that is, it can also thrive. See, we can't confuse leadership and managerial skills because you can have a great manager and get effective outcomes, all right?
Right.
And if you think about it, Hitler was a great leader. That doesn't mean the way he got his outcomes were effective. He didn't develop people, you know. So when you think about that, you want to also know that you can put people in position and they have different methods that they use and they can get effective and successful outcomes.
Right,
so
right.
So it does speak volumes. But I also believe that we are, as believers, have positions in workplaces that we are assigned to help bring that to that particular organization. And that's where that's my space, is when you are in your gift and you are in the workplace. If you are a believer, you are to carry that fragrance and you are to take that into the workplace. You are the light. So therefore, if you have a leader who is ineffective, that means we need to have other leaders. That's why it's important for platforms just as this one, as WOW, platforms that you have where you can utilize your voice and also your ability, your knowledge, your skill, and be promoted in the workplace so we can have kingdom men and women who are in authoritative positions and then they're also in influential positions so that they can actually make a change within those organizations. That is why it's critical for us to continue as kingdom builders to have positions within the organization.
Yes.
That's it.
Right, and I like that. And that's a great place to pause in comma, because I'm not going to say put a period, because we coming back to this. But thanks, Dr. Kim. That's some great information. And we certainly, I know, again, like it's mentioned, I know that we are helping the KHVN family out there with this wonderful information people are sharing with me as I pass them up. And so thank you. Thank you for sharing with us. So how can people reach you, Dr. Kim? How can they get in touch with you to hear more, see more, get their hands on your product?
Listen, go to my website. I love www. I love to interact and connect with the WOW listeners. DrKimberlyEllison.com, drkimberlyellison.com. Sign up so that you can get this, again, my calendar and everything. And we can also connect on social media. That's Facebook and Instagram at Dr. Kimberly Ellison. And you can go to Twitter at Dr. K. Ellison. Jermaine, I also want to share with my WOW listeners, I have an amazing class coming up. It's called Discipline and Preparedness. It is a Discipline and Preparedness intensive, and it's going to help you if you've been starting and stopping, if you're trying to lose weight, if you're trying to write a book, if you're trying to develop yourself, move into a career, finish school, whatever it is, and you keep being distracted or you are starting and stopping and getting in that cycle, you need to be in this virtual class July 8th. Check me out. Go to my Facebook page or even my website, and you'll be able to see and how to register. But again, Jermaine, I look forward to being back here right here on KHBN 970 AM next Wednesday.
All right, Dr. Kim, we look forward to it at that time. Thank you.
All righty.
All right, Dr. Kim helping us win on Wednesday, y'all. Just like that, you can get wonderful information to help you in the workplace and to help you with your daily life and activities. And so we definitely appreciate Dr. Kim. More great gospel music is on the way on Heaven 97 KHVN. While you're listening to the evening show, I'm Jermaine Simpson, your host.